Magandang umaga po sa ating lahat na naririto ngayon sa Shrine of Jesus of the Divine Word and sa ating mga taga-subaybay sa ating mga online masses around the world. Nawa yung pagpapala ng Panginoon po ay sumaating lahat ngayong araw na ito. In our gospel reading today, there seems to be a two underlying existential concerns. First is, will the seed grow? Lalago ba yung butil na inilagay sa iba't ibang klase ng kalupaan? These are images of hearts being ready, being prepared to receive something from the ground. And ito minsan tinatanong sa atin, we can see ourselves in the context of these seeds as well, because like the seed, there is a very remarkable question of life that seeks to ask us, lalago ka ba kung saan ka ipupunla? Will you grow even if the situation you are put in is difficult? Or will you cave in and just stay as a seed? The second concern is, what kind of soil is being referred to? Anong uri ng lupa na pwede kang itanim? Lingid sa ating kaalaman, mga kapatid, there is a peculiar way of farming among the Jews. For the Jews, one way of determining if the soil is rich or not is to just scatter the seed. Ano? They will just scatter seeds, and then if the seed will grow to be deeply rooted, then itong area na ito ay, ibig sabihin yung soil dito ay may rich, healthy yung soil. Kasi tatanungin natin, bakit pa kailangang mag-scatter? Diba? Bakit pa kailangang mag-scatter if the farmer already knows where to plant the tree or to scatter the soil? But it's one way for the Jews, as a matter of farming, to determine kung nasaan yung mataba at healthy na lupa. We can also reflect this in our lives, especially in our relationships, and ask ourselves, what kind of soil am I? What kind of friend am I? Am I the kind of friend that helps the other to grow and become deeply rooted in Christ? Is my friendship a friendship of one that is focused on the values of Christ? Or ako yung uri ng kaibigan na ipapahamak ko yung kaibigan ko? Just like the seeds that fell on the roadside. In-expose mo yung kaibigan mo, hinayaan mong kainin ng mga ibon. A friendship that protects is the opposite of that. And in our gospel for today, of course, the context is the readiness of the people to receive the Word of God. This is the main context of our gospel reading for today. And this example is exemplified by the readings in our first reading, because we heard the readiness of Jeremiah to receive the Word of God. The response in our first reading for today is a response that agrees and gives approval to the invitation of the Lord to follow Him and perform a mission. Masyado pa akong bata, Panginoon, pero because the seed of the Word of God has been received by a person who is ready, by a person who is willing, lumago yung salita ng Diyos. And ito yung mapupulot natin sa ating ebanghelyo in relation to our first reading. Nagiging handa lamang tayo sa mga bagay-bagay sa paligid natin kung at the very moment of our lives, we were already living a more conscientious way of life. If at the beginning, nagsimula na tayo ng tama, kung sa pasimula pa lamang ng ating pagkabata pa lang tayo, natuto na tayo ng mga bagay-bagay na kailangan nating matutuhan, the values, the principles of a follower and disciple of the Lord. Kaya it is an invitation for us, brothers and sisters, to examine what kind of environments we are living in. Kaninong boses yung nananaig sa ating mga tenga? Kaninong mga influence sa ating buhay ang mas binibigyan natin ng puang? Dahil dito, in these influences, we can learn what kind of disciple we are. Amen.